factorial urban ecological approach or the factorial ecological approach. This is a third approach, and we can say this is one of the latest approach to study urban land use. Now, this came after social area analysis. There were various criticisms to social area analysis, and to remedy those, this came as a remedial measure to the social area analysis. So, because the various criticisms, except for urbanization, that could be remedied, that were thought, the scholars, they tried to remedy the various problems that were there in urban, that were there in the social area analysis, through the use of more data and more statistical analysis. During this time, this occurred during 1970s, this sectorial urban ecology, this occurred in 1970s, around 1970s, 60s and 70s. So during this time, during 1960, we see the quantitative revolution in geography. Those of us who knows about geographical thought, all of us knows what is quantitative revolution in geography. So because of the quantitative revolution in geography during 1960s, what happened? There were a lot of data computing and data use, empirical uses that had come up. So during this time, then we could also, during that time in 1960s and 1970s, various data digitization had also come up, because GIS had also come by that time. So digitization of data, computing of data, statistical analysis, all these things had come up, and social science, because geography being a social science, so these things got linked to so geography, and geography became more empirical. And when the scholars could compute huge data, then this factorial urban ecology came into being. So we must understand that during this had come up when during the time of 1960s and 70s. Why? Because of the induction of the various statistical techniques, induction of computer technologies, etc. Now see, the social area analysis, they demonstrated how the, like, why this was required, why the factorial, this kind of approach was required. Because social area analysis, they demonstrated how quantitative analysis of data could be done by using various hypotheses, and how the social patterns of cities could be achieved. But during the 1960s and 70s, as I have told, there were society was much more complex. There were various variables, there were various components. And at the same time, during this time, 1960s and 70s, during this time, there were increasing amount of data became available because of the use of computer technology. So they could analyze large data, like just I have told right now. And during the same time, because there were huge amount of data, this computer technology had come up, GIS had come up, statistical analysis could be done, society became much more complex. So what happened? The social area analysis, they had become somewhat redundant. They had become somewhat old. So the recent studies of socioeconomic structure, socioeconomic characteristics, they took much wider variables. Whatever variables were suggested by Shefki and Bell, they used much more variables. So more analysis were done. So what is this? The use of a set of quantitative techniques, and these techniques are called factor analysis. It is known as factorial ecology. It became popular as a way to examine the ideas suggested by Shefki and Bell. So whatever the base point was based upon Shefki and Bell. So whatever techniques, whatever factors they used, more data was incorporated to study the, examine the ideas of Shefki and Bell. Now this is the person's sister who made this popular, this factorial ecology popular, and the term how the term came up. The term factorial ecology, it referred to the study of ecological differentiation of residential areas in urban and metropolitan areas. Now see, factorial ecology, when we study about factorial ecology, now what is it? What is factorial ecology? So factorial ecology is used to find the various social characteristics that is there in a city by using computer technology that I have already told about it. Now the characteristics that are considered over here, they are important in a city. So the whatever is important in that city, that is studied. It is not that like what was done in concentric zone theory, everything is studied. So no, whatever is important for that city, the only those characteristics are studied. It developed due to quantitative analysis in geography. And computer compares, like I have been saying, the computer compares or computer does the background work. Because in factorial ecology, it uses large data sets. And these large data sets, just like in SAA, they were using census data. Similarly, over here also census data is used. And this data is known as census tract. The census data is known as census tract. And then through computer, through statistical techniques, what is done? These census tracts, these data, they are mathematically examined. And the similarity or the dissimilarity is examined. So the linkage is the linkage, that is the linked characteristics are called the factors and given descriptive names. So what are the linked characteristics? Linked characteristics, can you can say these are the factors or these are the variables. The variables that are used, the variables that are used to find these out, they are called the factors. We will see the factors in the next slides. We will see what are the factors, and each of these factors are given descriptive name. It is not that whatever name has been predestined, like in SAA, it has been predestined that these are the factors. Over here, the factors may change according to the city. So once the analysis is completed, the city's land use pattern as a whole can be described. We will see about this. And over here, apart from the computer technology, what we see over here are various other statistical techniques are used over here, like PCA, the correlation, factorial analysis, etc. So these are all studied over here. Now over here, this over here, that is the descriptive names are given. So one of the basic difference with factorial ecology and the previous SAA is that in the SAA, the descriptive names were given beforehand, but over here, once it is understood, once it is studied, only then some name is given. It is that factor's name is given according to that. So over here, the factors describe the urban social space, and then the factors are identified by looking at the variables. So these terms, that is factors, the variables, these you will be seeing in the next few slides. So the factors are identified by looking at the variables. And these together, the factors and the variables, both of these together, they do what? They decide the land use pattern. So in factorial ecological approach, there are certain terminologies. That is, one terminology is factor, second terminology is a variable, and the third is the city's land use pattern. So this is the methodology in which so large data sets has been used. This is how it works. So you see a lot of factors. One of the most important, one important difference I have already told you, that is SAA is deductive, but this is not deductive. Over here, it empirically studies the various factors. Now, another thing is that in SAA, this in factorial urban ecology, it uses much more data set than what was used in SAA. So you can see a huge data set, large data sets are used, and based upon that, it is they decided that whether that city, whether that particular region can be segregated to which category. Now, for example, this place, this is of Illinois. Now, this region, this has been segregated as high income suburb, low income suburb, old inner suburbs, etc. These are based upon the, so these are the various factors, these are the various variables, these are the various variables over here. Now this urban, this is an example of urban mosaic, and this was given by Robert Moody in 1969. Now this is also a part of this urban mosaic theory. This is a theory. Urban mosaic theory is also a part of factorial ecology, because in factorial ecology, it is not only Switzer who had given his viewpoint. When they studied, when the results were found of factorial ecology, they also provided various ways for various other models. Because during this time, the Chicago School of Technology, Chicago School of Thought, they were studying the urban morphology. So while they were studying, so based upon this factorial ecology thought, this thought had also come up. So this thought is studied within factorial ecology. So in this thought, the various scholars like Robert Moody, he tried to find out ways how the three earlier models, that is the classical models, could be incorporated. Now, see over here, this is the economic status. It has been segregated as high economic status and low economic status. So this approach, it resulted from the intersection of the three primary forces. So what are the three primary forces? These are the three primary forces. So this resulted with the intersection of this force, and this force. Now, the, so according to Moody, the socioeconomic status, see over here, the high socioeconomic status means this, and low economic status means this loosely spaced. So that these are the places of the high economic status group, and these are the places of the low economic status group. So the city has been divided into sectors. So this is a sector of high economic status. This is a sector of low economic sector. So when we speak about sector, so Moody tried to link this to the Hoyt, wherein Hoyt had said that high income families would be located in a different sector. Now, family status, large families means people having more children, and small families, and younger and older with no children. So these are the various segregation. So this is the large families, that is with more children, and over here small families, and inside we are finding younger and older children. So the family organization, what happens over here, according to Moody, he's saying the younger singles and the elders would live in apartments, and smaller houses would be located closer to the city. And then the larger would go around this periphery. The largest families are having more children would be in the periphery of the city. So this represents the Burgess theory of concentric zone theory. So Moody tried to incorporate the family status with the Burgess theory. Now this is the ethnic status. So these are the various ethnic status, how the various racial peoples of various racial identities, they are staying in other enclaves or ghettos. So over here you are finding that this is a ghetto, or this is an enclave of one ethnicity, this is another ethnicity, this is another ethnicity. So this somehow reminds us of the multiple nuclei. This is the nuclei of the A ethnic people, B ethnic people, and C ethnic people. This is somehow multiple nuclei theory. So Robert Moody tried to link the ethnic status of social segregation with the multiple nuclei theory. And when these three special patterns are overlain on top of each other, maybe through GIS pattern, then what happens, then the area, this area, which is defined by the intersection of these three factors, This is almost the same as what Shefki and Bell has said. Try to remember the diagram which I have shown of San Francisco of Shefki and Bell. So because that one is also depending upon economic status, family status, and ethnic status, and ultimately based upon the interposition, superimposition of those three status, Shefki and Bell had come out with a composite pattern. Even Robert Murdy's composite pattern is almost the same as discussed by Shefki and Bell, although it is much more complex. Now, in factorial ecology, we study these so many factors. I have already said factorial ecology is almost like social area analysis. The only difference being in factorial ecology, we study huge data, more number of data, large set of census data. So this is only a representation of the various data sets that are taken. More data sets are taken. I will show that. And then these are according to their characteristics. These are sub-classified. So maybe certain things, certain place, this data sets has been sub-classified into social status. Some more have been reclassified or combined jointly, and now this joining combinedly is not done by manually what was done in classical theory. This combining is done through statistical technique and computer technique. So these are combined to find the family status, similarly ethnic status. So there are various status which can be done, and once this all these things are interposed, superimposed, then we have this, that is the city. We have this city. So the city has been divided into so many variables. So many variables leads to these factors. I have already told you about these terminologies, factors and variables. So these are the various variables, and these variables has been differentiated, reclassified into these factors. And then these factors and then done what? Then, and these has been obtained from what? Census data, also called as census tracts. I have already spoken about this, census data and census tracts, done through what? GIS technique, done through statistical techniques. And when all these are superimposed, what we get? We get the segregation of the city, and ultimately, so this is the city. So this is factorial ecology. Now let us understand, this is the social space of Toronto. So in Toronto, what we are seeing, see the map clearly. So these are the various segregation types, economic status, family status, ethnic status. So the high economic status, low economic status, this is the, again, families, large families, small families, the various economic status. So many things has been superimposed on top of each other. Now, this is a work which has been done, a research article which was published based upon the factorial ecology. Now, these are the various factors. These are the various variables. So this is only from 1 to 24 has been shown, but the research article from which I have taken it, it had 100 variables. So over here, it is written as variable. So 100 variables, over your variables are written. So 100 variables has been taken. I have taken only 24 to show you. So these variables has been taken. So when these variables has been taken, all these variables has been taken from census data. So when these things has been taken, next what factorial ecology does, I am telling you how the methodology works in factorial ecology. So these are the various variables which has been taken. Once the variables has been taken, they are then segregated into socioeconomic, family characteristics, ethnic characteristics. You can have demographic characteristics. You can have labor characteristics. Like this, various characteristics, it is differentiated. Now, just try to find the difference in SAA, social area analysis. First, these socioeconomic status is identified, family status is identified, ethnic status is identified, and then there are certain pre-decided variables which are given. and then that is searched throughout the city. But over it is just the opposite. Over here, first the variables are taken, whatever variables are there in that city. It is not necessary whatever variables has been taken in Toronto will be taken in Kolkata. Whatever variables are taken in Kolkata will be taken in Dublin. It is not that. Whatever variables are present in that particular city, those are taken. And once the variables are taken, then the variables are reclassified on the factors, that is the socioeconomic factor, family factor. So this is the other way around. I hope you have understood. In SAA, the factors are first taken. That is the these socioeconomic status and these things are taken, and then this is predestined. This is already pre-written what should be taken within each. But over here, first the variables are taken based upon that city's characteristics, and then the variables are reclassified according to the best possible characteristics. So these things, it has been found that this is socioeconomic. This is family, this is ethnic. There can be demographic, like I told you. So now this is then PCA, PCA and other correlation analysis is applied on these various other factorial analysis. These are all statistical techniques. Those of you who knows about this, who knows about statistical techniques, they would know what is PCA, what is correlation analysis, what is factorial analysis, they would know all these things. So over here, I have, these are two, again, this is from another research article, this is from another research article. So the factorial ecology of Kolkata is shown over here. Now see, the variables over here is not the same over here, because this is from other city, this is from another city. So this is what I was trying to say, that factors and variables are not the same. Like over here, the factors has not been named anything. In the previous slide, you were seeing that the factors were given a name, that is the socioeconomic status, etc. Over here, it has not been named anything. So, and over here, between these two, just try to compare these two. The variables taken over here and the variables taken over here are different, because the person who was doing this research, he, according to him, these were the important things for the city that he was trying to research. And for the person who was trying to do research on this Kolkata, this is 2001 census. So for him, he found these to be important variables. So when we use these variables, now obviously you can't use 100 variables. You can't do that manually. You need a certain kind of technique, computer technique. So that is what, that is why factorial ecology uses computer techniques. Now, through PCA, through factorial analysis, you will get these things called loading. So these are the loadings, 0.97, 0.494, 0.041. These are the loadings. So these are then divided into positive loading, negative loading. The negative loadings are not taken into consideration. The positive loadings will be taken, and upon that positive loadings, the ones which are the most positive will be taken, because that means that will have more emphasis on the characteristic of that city. Again, I am saying you, when these variables are taken, these variables are then in computer technology, in statistical analysis is done. And so when statistical analysis is done, what happens? Factorial analysis is a statistical analysis. Then what they do? Then they find directly we get positive and negative loading. These are the examples of some loading. So you see there are some negative loadings and there are some positive loadings. So the negative loadings are not taken. The positive loadings are taken. Why? Because the positive loadings means that variable will have more impact on the characteristic of that city. I hope this much is understood. Now what will happen? Now all the positive loadings are not taken. The positive loadings which has got more values, like this, take the factor 2. Except population density, the others are having more values. So these four will be taken. These four will be given more preference. Preference for what? Preference to make maps like this. So this is a map of Dublin. Again, I have given you another example. So till now, I have given you four types of examples. So this is another example of Dublin, Dublin city, wherein based upon the factors, low scores to high scores. So the scores are given based upon this mapping technique. Scores are given based upon the factors. So each factor will have each maps like this. So based upon the various factors, like you are seeing over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can also name the factors. You can name them like over here, family, ethnic, etc. You cannot name them also, factor 1, 2, 3, 4. Later on also you can name them, not a problem. Based upon these factors, you get maps like this. And based upon these maps, you get a composite map like this, that based upon the various factor scores, what happens? These kinds of maps are found. So in factor analysis, what is done? The various correlated indicators or the attributes which are related to each other, by combining all those correlated aspects, here the various aspects are combined, the indicators are combined. So by combining all those, an index has been found. Index are very high, medium, low, very low, etc. So these index have been found. So these are composite indices. So when you say very high, so the places over here, this very high region, we have this is an homogeneous area of very high, where the scores are ranging between this. When you say about high, this region, this is a homogeneous region. This homogeneous region has been found out by what? This is found out by the various correlation, by various factorial analysis, by various PCA, by various statistical analysis. This composite index has been found out, and based upon this composite indices, upon the various factors that has been taken, this area has been categorized as this high. So a factorial analysis, it tries to work like this. It uses the various scores, and based upon the scores, based upon the factors, it makes composite scores like this. Now there are certain similarities between the previous, that is the SAA, and also the factorial analysis. First is that both they are built upon the ecological perspective. That is what natural process emanates from the use of social space. So both comes out from the ecological perspective. Now what is natural process? The natural process has, when we speak about ecology, because ecology, again, ecology represents organisms. So when we speak about natural process, it comes out what? It is coming out through this concept of ecology, the concept of organism. Second is what? Social area identified by SAA are analogs to parks, natural areas, as are the neighborhood types identified by factorial ecology. So the areas, the maps that was built by SAA is almost the same to that of parks in the ecological approach, which was told to you much prior. So the parks social area, or the parks areas, that is Ezra Park. So Ezra Park's areas are almost the same to that of, that is the enclaves, the ghettos, etc. So parks, Robert Ezra Park's ultimate result, ultimate areas, ultimate segregated urban areas are almost the same as the areas identified by social area analysis. Similarly, both of these are same as to the end result of the factorial ecology. Third one is that both the perspectives, that is the SAA and factorial ecology, both the perspectives, they identify forces which is responsible for the organization and patterning of urban spaces. By now, I hope you know what are the various forces. So what are the various forces? The various forces are the social forces, the ethnic forces, the family forces. So both identified the forces that are responsible for the organizing and the patterning. There is one major difference. The difference being empirical analysis is conducted first and the factors are identified later. In the SAA, in the social area analysis, what they did was that they attempted to identify the factors first, and based upon that factor, they did the empirical analysis. But in the factorial analysis, because that was a deductive way, but in factorial analysis, what was that? They held the factors responsible for patterning the urban space. Thus, the empirical analysis was first conducted, like you are seeing in the previous slides. The empirical analysis were first conducted, and based upon the empirical analysis, that is the various variables, then they decided what? Then they classified the factors. So this is the major difference. Now these are the various criticisms. First of all, again the same criticism that has been used in the morphological analysis also, that is, you can't say that whatever has been said in factorial ecology for San Francisco or for some other city will be same for the other cities also, because culture is not the same everywhere. All the cities have varying type of cultures. Also, in some of the cities, there are various types of technology. So technology, there are various types of religious language. There are various types of languages, religion, various types of technological advancement. So based upon that, the city's development depends. So it is not the same. Secondly, the cities, various cities have got various types of land use. So you can't identify, compare city A with city B, because that will have various types of land use. Then the social status related with caste plays a very important role in particularly the Asian cities, because in Asian cities, caste and religion makes ethnic status. But in the European places, Europe, America, it may be the income, education may be making a different status, ethnic status. A color, skin color may make different ethnic status. But over here in Asia, it does skin color does not matter, it is caste. So there is various complications. You can't say that whatever has been said by sister in factorial ecology can be followed also in the Asian cities. Now to sum up, this is a very important slide. To sum up, we can say that urban morphology, urban land use goes through these four stages. In the first stage, we have the urban ecological approach, which was given by Park, later on also McKenzie. In stage two, we have the morphological approach, that is the classical theories of these three theories. In stage three, we have the social area approach, the SAA, which was given first by Schepke and Williams in 1949, and then remodified by Schepke and Bell. And also based upon this Schepke and Williams and Schepke and Bell, various other persons gave their theories, but it was mainly Schepke and William and Schepke and Bell. And then we have this last stage, that is the stage four, which is called the factorial analysis. And it was first given by Swister, and then it was modified by various other people, but based upon this Swister model. It was modified based upon Swister model. So this resulted in the various social areas. So this resulted, stage one resulted in the social areas, then we come to stage two, social area segregation, stage three, social area segregation, stage four, social area segregation. So this is the latest urban morphological stage or land use model of urban land use. So this is about the various urban land uses or urban land use theories that we study.